back to the full screen radar. Long key presses. Brings us back to full screen. The radar functions that we use most are under the Enter key. To make adjustments, to change values, we use the Adjust key. It highlights the menu on the right-hand side, and we can change the values, which are in automatic right now, automatic tuning, gain, and clutter.
Radar is a very useful feature for navigation. You automatically think that it's for collision avoidance, primarily for that, but it's not. It's really for three things. We use radar, of course, for collision avoidance, but we also use it for weather spotting. You can see weather patterns, you can see fronts, you can see fog banks quite some distance off. We also use it for navigation. You know how far off of a buoy or off of a shoreline you are on your GPS chart plotter. But if you also use the cursor on the radar to mark that coastline and check the range and bearing on that, it gives you a second source of information. If you check what's going on with your radar, the distance and the bearing to the beach, and on your chart plotter, the distance and the bearing to the beach, and then you look on your chart plotter and you see you're supposed to be in 48 feet of water, and your depth sounder says 45 feet of water or 48 feet of water, you've gotten three pieces of information that confirm that where you think you are is probably correct. That's safe navigation. We're using a split radar screen. The left-hand screen is a half-mile range. Here's that ship that passed us before. It's now in and turning for his berth. The right-hand screen is at an eighth of a mile range and shows targets that are very close up. Now watch as we turn on the radar overlay and the chart in the left-hand screen, and now the chart images come up underneath it. Here are the buoys on either side of us. Here's the ship turning in the center of the basin. These are cruise ships. And this is the long bulkhead over at Port Everglades, where that ship is going in right now. A lot of information on two screens, two different radar images, plus a chart image, all on one screen. And then with a single key press, we're back to the chart image. Here we are on the split screen. There's our location on the radar, right smack in the middle of the channel. And you can see here we are on the chart, right smack in the middle of the channel. There's a red mark just off our port, green off of our starboard. And these are the targets here on the radar screen. Large powerboat moving ahead of us here. Incoming target right next to him. Just appearing at the top of the screen, we'll show you, we'll go out to another range. There's a large container ship coming in. So we're going to move the range out. The radar redraws and the chart redraws to match that scale. We see a large target appearing out here. Right now I'm not sure if it's a buoy or what it is, but I'm going to move the cursor. And that's the location right there. Probably a vessel, not a buoy. There are two marks here, close side by side, and we're seeing them on the chart plotter here. We're going to go back to the radar overlay and see what it looks like there. The overlay is on now. These are the radar images of the land on top of the chart image. You see the buoys out here and the radar image for the buoys. Also notice a SIMRAD unique feature is that the radar targets, the actual radar targets themselves, do not obscure the nav aid that they're trying to represent. And that's because the designers very cleverly took the layer off the chart that has all of the nav aids and put it on top of the radar image. Nobody else does that. The radar picture of the buoy obscures the buoy that you're trying to see, but not with a SIMRAD nav station. As we're underway here, there's a white line on the radar screen from our position, which is the center of the circles, straight ahead of us. That's a heading marker. You see there's a large target
on that heading marker. That's that big Hatteras right in front of us. You'll see him just passing our position as well. There's a target just off to the left side of our position on the screen. And those blue patches to either side of the main channel are the various canals in Fort Lauderdale as we're getting down towards the 17th Street Bridge. Right at the very top of the screen, you'll see the drawbridge appearing. It's a large concrete steel structure. It's a good target for seeing on radar. On either side of the main channel, what looks to be docks, you're seeing mega yachts that are in the neighborhood of 80 to 120 feet long that are stationed, that are between us and the dock. On radar, you can't see a target that's behind another target. So the radar is not actually seeing the bulkhead or seeing the dock. It's actually seeing the boat that's moored to the dock. Just coming out from under the bridge, you'll see a large radar target. It's a catamaran-type sightseeing boat just coming through the bridge, and you can see it very clearly emerge from underneath the bridge target. Once we get through the bridge, we'll start to pick up the opening of the larger Port Everglades Basin, which is a major shipping port, and we should be able to see some cruise ships that are lying in their berths waiting to take folks out for their holiday weekends and holiday trips. The radar target now fades as we get under the bridge, and what you're seeing is the chart image of the bridge as we're directly under that bridge and radar doesn't look up. As we pass the bridge, you'll start to see the bridge radar image appear astern of us. There's a big target on our port side. That's the Queen M, another large mega yacht. On the starboard side is a massive radar target. And that's the Regal Princess, one of the Princess Cruise Line ships. Another powerboat approaching on our port side. You'll see that target very clearly. And the bridge is just disappearing off the bottom of the screen. Just appearing on the left-hand side of the screen are two navigation buoys. They're swinging around on our bow now as we're turning towards them. There's a red marker floating in the water, and then there's a green marker on a post. And in between them is a catamaran, a sailboat. You can see those three images. The center one is the catamaran. The right-hand one is the red buoy. The left-hand one is the stake, or the day mark. The overlay is on now. These are the radar images of the land on top of the chart image. You see the buoys out here and the radar image for the buoys. Also notice a SIMRAD unique feature is that the radar targets, the actual radar targets themselves, do not obscure the nav aid that they're trying to represent. And that's because the designers very cleverly took the layer off the chart that has all of the nav aids and put it on top of the radar image. Nobody else does that. The radar picture of the buoy obscures the buoy that you're trying to see, but not with a SIMRAD nav station. We're on the radar overlay image. Here's a very large radar target coming right between the buoys out there. And you'll see when we move the camera that a ship makes a very, very good radar target. The target coming at us, we want to know if we're going to clear all right. I'm moving the EBL, electronic bearing line, right on top of the target right here. Watch him come down the bearing line. If he comes all the way down the electronic bearing line, that's a collision. We need to make a decision here. We need to go one way or the other. If we turn to the left, he goes outside the bearing line and will pass outside and astern of us. If he had continued down that bearing line, that's a collision. That tells you slow down or make a dramatic change right now so somebody knows which way you're going. That's the electronic bearing line. Now we'll set the EBL on the left-hand side. That's number one. And we mark that first target. And number two marks the second target.